My YouTube channel. Welcome back to Jazzy Got Kicks, and for today's sneaker review, we'll be reviewing a pair of nines, specifically the Air Jordan 9 Kobes. These were originally released November 19, 2016. So enough of the chit chat, enough of the rada rada, let's get right into it, starting with, of course, our box. So we just have our standard black box, gold Jumpman, nothing spectacular. I think it would have been really nice if we would have got a special box, or maybe a purple box with a gold Jumpman. I think that would have been dope, but instead we have our standard box. So my tag is a little ripped, but I'm gonna try my best to remember what the color on this is. But you know, you normally have your size, color, barcode, and all that good stuff. But I believe the color on here is white, tour yellow, and concord. Yeah, tour yellow and concord. Here are the Air Jordan 9 Kobes. Of course, these were inspired by Kobe, and these were exclusively worn by Kobe during his period of sneaker-free agency in 2002 to 2003. Here they are side by side. I'm gonna put one shoe down momentarily. Let's get into the rest of the details. Now, when these originally came out for Kobe to wear during the 2002 and 2003 season, I do believe it had the original 8 on the back, which of course was Kobe's number, but they replaced the original 8 with Jordan's brand signature 23 on our back heel. And I kind of wish they would have left it with Kobe's original number. I think that would have been super dope. Even if they didn't leave it at 8, make it 24. I don't like that they went ahead and added Jordan's number to the back. If this is a Kobe-inspired sneaker, then why not just leave his number back there? So I really don't like that they went ahead and put the signature 23 that we see on all pairs of Air Jordan 9s anyway. The only Air Jordan 9s that come to mind that don't have 23 on the back, of course, are the Air Jordan 9 Kilroys, and the Air Jordan Baron 9s that has 45 on the back, and I think the Kilroy has number 4, if I'm not mistaken. But those are like the only 9s that come to my mind that don't have the 23 on the back. I'm sure it might be a few other ones, but those are like the main two that come to my mind. So due to the fact that this was a Kobe-inspired sneaker, I think they should have left the 8 alone, and I think it would have made for a very more iconic shoe. It's still iconic because it's Kobe, but it would have been even more iconic if it would have kept his number on the back. It doesn't break the shoe, but it's just my personal opinion. So as you guys can see, we have this nice white leather upper with this Concord patent leather overlays that we got going around the entire shoe, even back here to our heel. We have these nice silver accents right here where our laces are, and our yellow accents, which include our Jumpman 23 on the back and the Air Jordan written on the tongue, which I think should have said Kobe. I think Kobe Bryant's name here would have been a nice touch, but kept it standard, kept it Air Jordan, so you know.
So because I didn't mention it in the video, I just wanted to put on screen how much the Air Jordan 9 Retro Kobes are going for. As you guys can see, they are pretty expensive, definitely above retail, which was $190. You're pretty much paying anywhere between $200 to $500 for these. But look at this next slide. You see what 12 and a half is going for? You know my response to that already.
Fuck no, baby!
So yeah, these do not come with extra laces. So to the people that like lace combinations, you don't get another pair of laces with these. You get your standard white laces. But hey, if you want to switch up your laces, you can always buy laces and have as much fun as you please. But I was just letting you guys know in case you guys were wondering. Overall, I really like this shoe. Minus my little nitpicks, I do think it's a classic pair of nines. Probably one of the best Air Jordan 9s. Probably wouldn't be in my top 5, but I'd probably incorporate these in my top 10. So yeah, that pretty much wraps up this sneaker review. Please leave your thoughts and opinions in the comment section down below. What do you think about the Air Jordan 9 Kobes? Do you like these? Do you own these? Do you agree with my thoughts that it should have kept his number on our back heel? Do you think that it's no problem having the 23 as usual? Leave your thoughts down below, and of course, if I see it, I will respond back so we can get a discussion going. So until my next sneaker review, please be sure to follow me on Instagram, which is @_JazzyMonet_, and my business page, which is @BedstyFinesse_INC. So until next time, peace and blessings. Keep the kick game strong, and most importantly, rest in peace, Kobe Bryant, and rest in peace, Gigi Bryant. Keep the kick game strong, guys. Next, somebody say, yeah, yeah, yeah.